In CHR, we've been focusing over the last several years on occult ovarian problems. And there are a couple of parameters that we look at to try to understand ovarian reserve. We're looking at two laboratory tests, the FSH and the AMH. Now, FSH is follicle stimulating hormone, which clearly is the hormone that stimulates follicles. AMH stands for anti-Müllerian hormone, which makes, the name makes no sense in this context, so we just call it AMH. Follicle stimulating hormone levels change as ovarian function changes, and they don't change suddenly, they go up sort of slowly as a woman ages. So there's a certain level of follicle stimulating hormone we expect to see when you're 25, when you're 30, when you're 35. And if you end up having a level when you're 25 that would be normal for when you're 35, that's not normal for you. And so it suggests that there's a subtle change in the way your ovaries are functioning. In a similar way, AMH is a measure of how many active follicles you have in your ovaries, those that are just on deck, ready to come into the next cycle. There are some things that can affect AMH levels, but in general, it's pretty steady. We don't have to measure on any particular day. A normal level of AMH means you have the normal number of eggs ready to come into the next cycle that we expect you to have for your age. When AMH becomes undetectable, it means that you have very few of these follicles left. Usually, it doesn't become undetectable until a woman is in her mid-40s. But if your AMH levels are lower than we expect them to be for your age, then that's another sign that your ovarian reserve is less than we would normally expect it to be. CHR has a long experience of taking care of women who have these sort of functional changes in their ovarian reserve. We use particular ways of inducing ovulation. We try to prepare the ovary prior to inducing ovulation with things like androgen preparations like DHEA. We encourage our patients to take supplements like CoQ10. And together, we feel that we're getting better results, better egg production, but more importantly, higher quality eggs and embryos when we get there. Recently, we've been looking at the androgen profiles in general, and we've noted that particular changes in the androgen profiles can reveal themselves that other people sometimes don't see. And you have to look at all these numbers in concert. In the last 2 months, I've had three people who came to me who were told by other doctors that they were menopausal because their FSH was very, very high. But when we looked at their AMH was normal, and their androgen levels were so low that they were undetectable. It turned out that these people each had some degree of adrenal insufficiency, not enough to make them sick, but enough so that their ovaries were not getting some of the raw material they needed from their adrenal gland in order to function normally. And one of these people became pregnant immediately after we started her on some androgen supplementation, and the others had ovarian function restored simply by giving them some androgen supplementation. So these cases are rare. CHR is known to take care of unusual cases, so they come to us. But it just shows you have to look more carefully to fully understand what's going on when you're dealing with these people.